Hello viewers, let us know about meat quality. Meat is the edible post-mortem component of live animal. The animals include domesticated cattle, buffaloes, sheep, goats, pigs and poultry birds. Meat is a skeletal tissue from an animal carcass. The animal carcass is devoid of skin and internal organ meats. The organ meats such as liver, heart, kidney, and lungs are considered as variety meats. The carcass is in the range of 45% to 50% of live animal weight. The carcass yield in the case of pigs is around 70% of live weight because the skin is edible and comes along with the carcass. Also, the birds, especially broiler chickens, yield carcass with skin as high as 65% to 70% of live weight. The carcass of slaughtered animals consists of three parts. They are muscle, fat and bone. The carcass composition differs significantly between different meat animals. Muscle is the major constituent of the slaughtered weight of the animal. Fat deposits and sometimes bones are often processed and marketed along with muscle. Consumer expects certain quality characteristics in foods. Quality is degree of excellence. Quality embraces intrinsic composition, nutritive value, degree of spoilage, damage, deterioration, hazard to health, aesthetic considerations, yield and profitability to the producer. The following aspects pertaining to meat quality are studied in this topic. Nutritional quality of meat. Meat quality parameters for consumers. Cold contraction and rigor mortis. Pale, soft and exudative and dark, firm and dry muscles. Meat emulsions. Estimation of proximate composition of meat. Let us now know something about nutritional quality of meat. Meat has been used as human food since time immemorial. Meat components are moisture, protein, lipid, ash and carbohydrate. These components vary in meats from different animal species considerably. Accumulation of lipid is the most significant variation. On average, most meats contain about 18% protein, 5% lipid including essential fatty acids, 1% ash, potassium, phosphorus, sodium, chloride, magnesium, calcium and iron, and 1% carbohydrate containing glycogen antemortem and lactic acid postmortem, and the rest 75% as moisture. Protein is main nutrient in meat with essential amino acids and excellent digestibility. Digestibility of meat proteins is more than 90% as against about 65% in the case of plant proteins. Meat also provides many vitamins and all B vitamins. Now let us know about quality parameters for consumers. The meat quality parameters for the consumers are its color, flavor, texture, including tenderness and juiciness. The distribution of fat inside the muscle, that is intramuscular fat, is called as marbling and is important characteristic of quality in meat animals. The degree of marbling depends on maturity of the animal and feeding practice. Marbling should be moderate to give proper taste and flavor. Too little marbling gives dry and flavorless product. Too much marbling lowers the eating quality of meat as consumers prefer lean meat. Marbling also imparts juiciness to meat. Color is a visual indicator of meat quality. Color of meat varies from pale pink to dark red. Darker color is due to older age of animal. High degree of microbiological contamination and too much drying can cause discoloration of meat. The color of fat varies from creamy white to orange yellow. Dark yellow color of fat indicates older animal. Flavor. Raw meat has a serum-like or blood-like bland flavor. During conversion of muscle to meat, the flavor components become more intense as the meat passes into rigor. There is a gradual loss in flavor during storage. This occurs even in frozen condition, possibly due to the loss of highly volatile substances. Undesirable flavor may arise due to microbial growth, chemical deterioration, and tainting by extraneous agents. On cooking, the flavor is altered to produce delicious flavor of cooked meat. Feeding of different plants affects meat flavor. Sheep fed with lucerne, white clover, and sweet glycine results in sharp odor. Rye grass, panic grass, green grass, and kikuyu grass gives strong meat odor, and rape grass causes sickly odor. Let us know about meat texture. Postmortem handling of carcasses influences the quality of meat, especially texture that includes tenderness and juiciness. Texture is rated most important among eating quality attributes. The overall impression of texture involves the initial ease of penetration of meat by teeth, the ease with which the meat breaks into fragments, and the amount of residue remaining after chewing. Cold contraction and rigor mortis. After death of the animal, there is a discontinuation of blood supply to muscle and anaerobesis sets in. The obvious physical change is the loss of extensibility in muscle, called as rigor mortis. The lactic acid formed in the glycolysis goes on accumulating, giving rise to acidification. Acidity of muscle is measured by pH. The pH is defined as the logarithm of the reciprocal of the hydrogen ion concentration, which is mathematically expressed as pH is equal to log base 10 1 divided by concentration of hydrogen ion. The pH begins to decline from about 7, its pre-slaughter value, until it reaches 5.3, called as ultimate pH. The rigor sets in and cross bridges formed between actin and myosin proteins to form actomyosin complex, giving rise to inextensibility and rigidity. The contraction undergone by the muscle during rigor is temperature dependent, and drastic shortening occurs at very low and very high temperatures. Rapid chilling of carcasses or muscles soon after slaughter results into contraction of muscles. This cold contraction produces toughening in meat. The meat so toughened cannot be improved by aging or cooking. When carcass or muscle is held at 15 to 20 degrees Celsius, the cold shortening is minimal. Toughening due to cold contraction on rapid chilling can be overcome by postmortem conditioning of carcass. The carcass conditioning technique involves suspending the carcass through pelvis instead of conventional Achilles tendon, and holding initially at 20 to 25 degrees Celsius for 6 to 8 hours, followed by chilling at 3 to 4 degrees Celsius for 16 to 18 hours. After about 24 hours, the carcass can be fabricated into cuts, which can be merchandised as chilled pre-cut or frozen and stored. Pelvic suspension of carcass stretches muscles, especially thigh muscles. Stretched muscles are tender. Rigor shortening and cold shortening occurring in muscle postmortem are two different phenomena as explained below. Rigor shortening occurs slowly in muscles after many hours of slaughtering. It occurs at low pH below 6 and at low ATP levels below 1 micromoles per gram in muscles. Postmortem, it occurs in both red and white muscles. Whereas cold shortening occurs more rapidly in a few minutes after reaching low temperature when the muscle pH is still high, that is over 6. It occurs at high ATP levels of more than 5 to 6 micromoles per gram in muscles postmortem. This occurs more in red muscles from sheep goat, buffaloes and cattle, and to a lesser extent in white muscles from rabbit and pig. Advantages of carcass conditioning are the technique can be easily adopted in the existing meat chilling plants. It only requires S-type hooks for fastening through pelvis instead of gambrel for Achilles tendon. It improves the eating quality characteristics of meat. It reduces the cooking time by 50% and saves fuel energy. It renders choice cuts suitable for roasting and broiling. In India, large quantity of meat comes from aged animals. This meat is quite tough. The tenderness of meat from these animals can be significantly improved by this carcass conditioning process. Let us know about pale, soft, exudative and dark, firm and dry muscles. State of animal just prior to slaughter and conditions of slaughter influence the meat quality. Although meat is normally used or processed after it has gone into full rigor, pre-rigor muscle has some advantages over post-rigor meat. The advantages are the high water holding capacity, greater ability to emulsify fat, formation of more stable emulsion, a more stable red color, a lower susceptibility to oxidation, and economical due to rapid turnover and greater energy saving. The manner in which the live animals are handled prior to slaughter and carcasses muscles post slaughter results in the muscle conditions which pale, soft, exudative PSC and dark, firm and dry DFT muscles. The characteristics of PSC and DFT muscles are explained below. PSC characteristics are: muscle is light or pale in color, soft, watery, lean and has open structure. Pale color results from light colored precipitates of sarcoplasmic proteins masking the usual color. Muscle exudates renders meat unattractive and accumulates as excess fluid in prepackaged fresh chops and roasts. PSC condition occurs normally in pork and occasionally in beef. Open structure allows taking up of curing salts more readily. Due to rapid drop in pH, it retards microbial growth and hence incidence of spoilage is less. PSC condition results from an extremely rapid rate of glycolysis postmortem, especially in stress susceptible pig, while muscle temperature is still high. Rapid fall in pH results in precipitation of sarcoplasmic proteins on the myofibrils. Glycogen content is lower and lactate concentration is higher, even double, in PSC than in normal muscle. Adenosine triphosphate ATP and creatine phosphate CP concentrations are also lower. Time taken for completion of rigor is greatly reduced in PSC muscle. PSC muscle proteins are more easily soluble in salt solution and its collagen is more heat labile. The characteristics of DFD muscles are: muscle is dark in color, firm in texture and dry to touch. DFD is associated with low glycogen reserves and low reducing sugar levels at the time of slaughter. Meat feels sticky to touch and has closed structure and high pH. Muscle does not absorb curing salts readily and hence more susceptible to bacterial spoilage. Absence of glucose at the surface of DFD meat allows the spoilage microflora to degrade the amino acids and form odorous compounds earlier in spoilage process. DFD meat has objectionable soapy taste. Incidence of DFD can be reduced by minimizing the amount of stress during handling of live animals and during slaughter. DFD muscle proteins are less soluble in salt solution and its collagen is less heat labile. Now let us know about meat emulsions. Oil does not mix with water because of interfacial tension between the two layers. The chemical compound that can reduce the interfacial tension and helps mixing the oil and water is called emulsifier. Proteins are natural emulsifiers because they contain hydrophilic and hydrophobic amino acids. An emulsion is a heterogeneous system consisting of at least one immiscible liquid intimately dispersed in another in the form of droplets of diameter less than 0.1 micrometer. Emulsifying capacity of meat is measured as ml oil emulsified per 100 gram soluble proteins. Amino acid composition and sequence, molecular weight, conformation and charge distribution on the molecule affect functional properties of proteins. Emulsion type meat products have better sensory quality attributes. Oil in water and water in oil are two types of emulsions, which are explained as below. The characteristics of oil in water are: oil droplets are dispersed in water. Water is a continuous phase. Electrical current is conducted due to transmission through the continuous water phase. Emulsions are creamy, favored by hydrophilic emulsifiers, stabilized by sodium soaps. The characteristics of water in oil are: water droplets are dispersed in oil. Oil is a continuous phase. Electrical current not conducted due to the insulating properties of discontinuous nature of water phase. Tend to be oily and greeny, favored by hydrophobic emulsifiers, stabilized by magnesium and calcium soaps. Functional properties of proteins include solubility, water holding capacity, fat binding capacity, gelation and elasticity. The functional properties affect the taste, flavor, texture and acceptability of products. Water holding capacity. The ability of muscle to hold fast its own water as well as added water is called as water holding capacity of muscle. Muscle proteins are water holders in meat. Hydration of meat is closely related to juiciness quality of meat, which in turn influences the tenderness and taste of meat. Drip loss, thawing loss, cooking loss and expressible juice measure water holding capacity of meat. Water is present in meat in two forms, bound water and free water, which are explained below. The characteristics of bound water in muscle are: bound water is a true hydration, structural or protective water. It is only 4 to 5% of total water, tightly bound on surface of protein molecule. Non-polar amino acid residues bind this fraction of cellular water. Bound water is hardly influenced by changes in structure and charges of muscle proteins. Bound water is vital for survival of the living organism and it cannot be frozen or evaporated without destroying the organism. Now let us know about free water. Its characteristics are: free water is immobilized water and is biologically active. Free water is immobilized by myofibrillar proteins. It is located in myofibrils and sarcoplasmic reticulum. This water is held by polar groups of side chains of proteins, example carboxyl group, amino group, hydroxyl group, sulfhydryl groups and peptide bonds. Free water is highly influenced by changes in structure and charges of muscle proteins. Free water is needed by biosystems at the peak of biological activity. Now, estimation of approximate composition of meat. Meat is minced and aliquot samples are taken for estimation of moisture, lipids, that is fat, ash and protein by the methods briefly described below. Moisture content. 10 gram minced meat in petri dish is transferred to oven maintained at 100 plus or minus 2 degrees Celsius, keep there for 18 hours approximately, take out petri dish from oven, cool in desiccator, weigh and calculate moisture content. Moisture content in sample is equal to weight of fresh sample minus weight of dried sample. Moisture content percentage value is equal to moisture content in sample divided by weight of fresh sample into 100. Fat content is also called as ether extract. Powder the dried meat sample in mortar and pestle. 2 gram dried meat sample is taken in thimble and fat extracted by petrolium ether, which has got a boiling point of 40 to 60 or 60 to 80 degrees Celsius in Soxhlet extraction unit, and fat content is calculated. Fat content is on dry waste basis is expressed as fat content in dried sample divided by weight of dried sample into 100, and fat content on wet weight basis is expressed as fat content on dry weight basis into 100 minus moisture content of fresh sample divided by 100. Ash content. 15 gram minced meat in crucible is incinerated by holding the crucible with sample on flame till smoke subsides. Transfer to muffle furnace maintained at 450 to 500 degrees Celsius for 16 to 18 hours. The furnace is switched off. Crucible is transferred to desiccator, cooled, weighed, and the ash content calculated. Ash content on percentage wise is equal to ash content in sample divided by weight of fresh sample into 100. Protein content. Muscle protein contains 16% nitrogen. Estimation of nitrogen in meat is done, and the nitrogen content is then multiplied by 6.25 to obtain protein content. Reagents used are digestion mixture prepared by adding 98 grams of potassium sulfate and 2 grams of copper sulfate. Other reagents are 40% sodium hydroxide solution, N by 10 sulfuric acid solution, and N by 10 sodium hydroxide solution. Methyl red indicator is prepared by 0.1 gram of indicator dissolved in 60 ml ethanol and 40 ml distilled water. 2 grams of minced sample in Geldol flask, add 1 gram digestion mixture, 20 ml concentrated sulfuric acid and glass beads to prevent bumping. Heat till digest is clear, cool, add excess of 40% sodium hydroxide, distill to liberate ammonia and receive ammonia in 25 ml of N by 10 sulfuric acid solution. Titrate excess acid in the receiver against N by 10 sodium hydroxide using 3 to 4 drops of methyl red indicator. A reagent blank is similarly digested and distilled to obtain blank titrate value. Protein content in fresh meat is equal to C minus B into 14 into D into 6.25 into 100 divided by A into 1000, where A is a weight of fresh minced sample, B ml of alkali required for neutralization of 25 ml of standard N by 10 sulfuric acid solution, C ml alkali required for back titration to neutralize excess acid, and D normality of alkali. Conclusion. Meat supplies micro, that is vitamins and minerals, and macro, proteins and lipids, nutrients to the human body. Cattle, buffaloes, sheep, goats, pigs and chicken are the main meat producing animals in India. Color, flavor, texture, comprising tenderness and juiciness are the prime meat quality parameters, of which texture is rated highest by the consumers. Handling of animals during slaughter and subsequent storage of carcass affect meat quality. Improper handling and processing lead to undesirable PSC and DFD conditions in meat. Suspension of carcass by pelvis soon after slaughter and dressing, holding at above 20 degrees Celsius till the muscle pH is 6 or below, followed by chilling at 2 to 4 degrees Celsius for overnight improves tenderness quality of meat by preventing cold contraction of muscles. Pre-Raigar meat is better than post-Raigar meat for the preparation of meat products. Meat proteins are excellent emulsifiers as they contain both hydrophilic and lipophilic amino acids.